revisiting earlier thoughts. How can you protect each network from malicious traffic that originates inside of those networks themselves? Firewalls, as we said, sit on the border between the trusted inside network and the untrusted outside. The malicious traffic that originates on the inside can't be filtered by a firewall that's at the edge. It's already in. Furthermore, what happens to traffic that evades the firewalls? The answer to these important questions is either an IDS, intrusion detection system, or an IPS, intrusion prevention system. Before we talk about the difference between an IDS and an IPS, let's just lump the two of them together and discuss how they are different than firewalls. Think of the firewall as the person looking at your boarding pass and ID at the airport before you get to your gate. He's checking what is really the equivalent of the source IP address, who you are, where you live, the destination IP address, where you're flying to, the protocol, your airline, and the port, your flight number. Even with DPI, deep packet inspection, he's still using a set of pre-configured rules. He might ask you what you do for a living or why you're going to a particular destination. The IDSs or IPSs would be the security guards on the other side, by the gates where the people wait to board their planes. A passenger who got by the initial screening might start causing problems by the gate, possibly getting loud and violent over the delay of a flight. He might even be entering areas restricted for airport employees. The firewall, the TSA screener who looked at your boarding pass, can't help at this point. The problem exists beyond that location now. The IDS or IPS kicks in, which requires more logic and learning. IDSs and IPSs have to make decisions on where certain lines were crossed and then take appropriate action. The firewall, the TSA agent looking at your boarding pass, is still a very necessary component. If everyone was just let through to the gates, the airport guards would be overwhelmed and wouldn't be able to monitor all potential passengers. The firewall weeds out those that shouldn't go in, but the IDS or IPS adds a new dimension for those passengers that made it past the first screening.